Hey, good morning, Lorenzo. Y'all have a good Thanksgiving? Yeah? Good time with family and food?
Yes, sir, and the other two girls should be here shortly.
Okay. Well, I'll just wait until they get here. To do my little introduction, okay? When you say shortly, how shortly?
I don't know because they're taking basketball pictures right now.
Okay, well then I'll go ahead and get going. So we are in our, I say it's our final 2 weeks of classes, week 14 and 15. So we have this week and next week of classes. During that time, we will be dealing with systems of equations, nonlinear systems, systems of inequalities, determinants and Cramer's rule, and we'll see if we get into the binomial theorem. And also in that time, we'll have opportunity to address questions from the review for the final exam. And our final exam is in really 2 weeks from now, is our final exam. That's December 13th, I believe, from 8 to 10. Excuse me. So, a couple of things. So today we're working on assignment 23, matrix solutions to systems of equations. I've set aside today and Wednesday to talk about it. We'll see if we need to utilize Wednesday as well. We'll just see how today goes and where y'all are at on Wednesday. I was made aware that for assignment 25, which is nonlinear systems and systems of inequalities, that I do not have any notes or lecture videos for that assignment. I seriously doubt that I'm going to be able to get the videos made in time for even Wednesday, maybe for Friday, I can get them made. But what I'm planning to do at this point is to just have some traditional in-class lecture over assignment 25, and that will happen either on Wednesday or Friday. And that will also change if I get the videos made in time for those sections. I'm working on the notes right now. And if I have time, I will get those videos made. And then we can just have that in-class question and answer over those sections. Yes, right now there are no notes or videos for assignment 25. I'm aware of that. So at this point today, I'm curious as to where y'all are at with assignment 23, matrix solutions to systems. Are y'all working on the homework or what?
Yes, we're still working on it.
Still working on it. Okay. In the last class, I let them work on the homework for time. I'm around to answer questions. We got started on addressing a 3x3 system, and we got started a little bit late. I would like to, if there's any questions, I'd like to get to them sooner than I did in the last period, but I'm going to let y'all work for a little bit before I open the door for questions. Well, actually, if you have questions now, that's fine with me. But if you don't, I'm just going to let y'all work a little bit. I'm going to get some work done as well. And we'll just start there. Okay? Sound good? All right. Okay, how's it going? Good? Any questions? Okay. All right, how we doing? Hello. Do we have any questions so far? Nope. Okay. Okay. I mean, y'all been working on the homework. Question. The first, what? One, two. The first two problems are 2x2 systems. Those should be fairly straightforward. But do we have any questions on the first two problems? Okay. What about starting with problem number three, the 3x3 system? Are we, I see heads shaking this way. Does that mean we have no issue with it, or does it mean that we don't know what's going on?
No, there's no issues.
No issues. Okay. So you've done problem number three, I take it?
Yes, but on problem number five, can you go over that one, please?
We can start to go over it. I love to explain things. So, when I explain things, I don't know if we always get through it, but we'll do what we can.
Because I don't know how to do the B part. The B part got me a little confused.
Okay, let's look at problem number five. All right, so I'm just going to go straight into the augmented matrix. I'm not going to write the system down. Now notice equation one, there is no x. So we need to go straight into the augmented matrix. Since there is no x for row one, you have to throw in a zero for that coefficient. Then your coefficients for your y and z are 3, then negative 1, and row 1 equals negative 1. Then when I look at row 2, my coefficients for x, y, and z are 1, 5, negative 1, and that equals negative 4. And then row 3, my coefficients for x, y, and z are negative 3, 6, 2, and then 11, and that equals 11. Okay, so there's my augmented matrix. Everybody good with that? Now, I like to keep in mind my goal, especially for teaching purposes. Our goal is to get our matrix reduced to what's called row echelon form using Gauss-Jordan elimination. Our goal is to get, basically we have a diagonal of ones, zeros above and below the diagonal, and it's going to be equal to A, B, and C. That's our goal. So when we start off, let's take a the first goal that you want to have is you want to make this first element in row one a one. We want the first element in row one to be a one. Now, when I look at my augmented matrix, that's a zero. So I don't want zero right here, I want one right here. So, how do I make this first element in row one a one? You can do matrix or row addition, subtraction. You can do row swapping. I'm asking you this question. What are you going to do to make this this element, the first element in row 101, what would you do?
Would you add one to the row?
You can't add one. You cannot add one to a individual row.
So then would you add it to the whole matrix?
Sorry, can you say that again, please?
So then would you have added the one to the whole matrix, or?
No, you can't. So you cannot add one to an individual row. You cannot add numbers to an individual row. You can add rows together. You can add rows together. You can multiply a row by a number, but you can't add or subtract a number from an individual row. Let me offer you a suggestion. That's a one right there. So what if I just swap row one and row two? Would that achieve the goal of getting a one as the first element of row one, just doing a swap? Yeah. So here's my suggestion. If you can do a row swap, swapping rows is perhaps the easiest mathematical thing to do with matrix operations. Just swap rows. So here's my very fancy way to indicate that. What we're going to do is we're going to swap row one and row two. So this now becomes the following. 1, 5, negative 1, negative 4, 0, 3, negative 1, negative 1, and then negative 3, 6, 2, 11. So, have we achieved the first goal of getting a 1 as the first element of row 1? Yes. Now, what you want to do after that is you want to start getting zeros, if you can, below this one. Now, look what just happened. Next goal is to get a zero below that one. Well, that's our current situation, isn't it? We got a zero below the one in row one. The next goal is to get this to be zero. Now, the nice thing about having a 1 right here is the following. To make this element a 0, we want to make this negative 3 a 0, I can just multiply 1 by whatever I need it to be and add it with row 3. So we're thinking about adding row 1 and row 3 together in order to make this first element in row 3 a 0. So what do I need to multiply row 1 by? If I'm going to add it to row 3, what do I need to multiply row 1 by if I'm going to add it to row 3 to make this a 0? Everybody's holding up a 3. Good. So here's my line instructions. I'm going to take 3 times row 1 and add it to row 3. So the way I do this is, number one, my instructions are in line with the row that I'm manipulating. So since my instructions are in line with row 3, the only row that I'm going to manipulate is row 3. Row 1 and row 2 are not changing. Row 1 and row 2 are not changing. But now I'm going to go through and I do this mentally. You can do the work off to the side if you need to, but I'm going to do it mentally. 3 times row 1, so 3 times 1 is 3. Add it to negative 3. 3 plus negative 3 is 0. 3 times 5 is 15. Plus 6 is going to be a 21. 3 times negative 1 is a negative 3. Plus 2, that's going to be negative 1. And 3 times negative 4 is a negative 12 plus 11, that's going to be negative 1. Now, we have gone and we have achieved the goal of getting zeros below the 1 in row 1, or in column 1, I should say. Now, at this point, there's a couple of things that you could do, and I guess let's just trudge through this. We're going to make some fractions. Normally, I don't like making fractions, but for the sake of time, we're going to deal with fractions. Let's see, what could we do to deal with some fractions? I want to make this 3 a 1. So how do I make that 3 a 1? We're going to take 1/3 of row 2. Row 1 does not change. A third of row 2. So we're going to multiply, divide everything by 3. We get 0, 1, negative 1/3, negative 1/3. Row 2 does not change. Or excuse me, that's row 3. Now, going back to my goal, so we just we've made that a 1. Now what we want to do is we want to make zeros below and above that 1. So, let me suggest to you the first operation, and you're going to tell me the second one. If I want to make this 5 a 0, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take negative 5 times row 2 and add it to row 1. Let's see what that does. So first of all, row 2 does not change. Row 2 is staying as it is.
Your conference is scheduled to end in 2 minutes.
Let's do the math. Negative 5 times 0 is 0, plus 1 is 1. Negative 5 times 1 is a negative 5, plus 5 is 0. All right, so negative 5 times 1/3 is a positive 5/3. So I got a positive 5/3 plus a negative 1, so that's going to be minus 1. So that's the same thing as 5/3 minus 3/3. That's going to be 2/3. That becomes 2/3. And then negative 5 times a negative 1/3, that's going to be positive 5/3. Minus 4, that's going to be the same thing as minus 12/3. So that's going to be a negative 7/3. All right, so we introduced some fractions. That's okay. Hopefully things are going to work out nicely here in a little bit. Now, here's where I want to ask you the question. Do you see how I got this 5 to become a 0? You tell me, what's the row operation that I'm going to use? I'm going to use row 2 and row 3. What's my row operation that I'm going to use to make this 21 become 0? You tell me.
Your conference is now over. Goodbye.
Well, you're going to have to tell me on Wednesday.